And we are on. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to a very special presentation of T3G Plays. I am Cerebro and...
Harris.
I guess we're doing that now. Well, my name's Dalibor. Dalibor. D-A-L-I-B-O-R.
Yes. None of this full throttle and Cerebro anymore.
Dalibor, a.k.a. Cerebro. Call me what you want. Right. We're here on the last day of the Battlefront beta.
Literally the last day.
The absolute last day of the Battlefront beta. And we thought we'd give it a whirl. We've been playing a little bit this morning. Figured we'd share our thoughts on the game. So no better way than just get into it.
Agreed.
Drop zone. 75% full servers. Are we on the same map this time? Same team? Yeah, we are.
Yeah, it allowed me to join. So as soon as you joined, it said click here to join. Mm. So it allowed me
Okay, so it gives you like a like an option.
Well, that's what it did. As soon as you, I guess, clicked play game, whatever, it allowed, like, it invited me or saying that. Same in the upper left corner, it said, hey, you joined the game you want to play.
Gotcha. So what I will say, guys, is I have my game here set to the absolute lowest graphics you possibly could have.
And I have it at max.
So we already lost. Damn.
Hey, we didn't even join the game.
Damn. Damn.
That's good. That means we don't have to. We can actually start fresh and show off the game and stuff like that. But that being said, while we're waiting for the next part.
When on Ultra, I think it's gorgeous. Game
so
is
this
beautiful.
Game is graphically amazing. It truly is. The fact the requirements are ridiculous.
Yeah, they are. I'm just edging in at 32 gigs of RAM.
It kind of shows why we always talk about why certain things are just not enough RAM things. This game's requirements, recommended requirements, are a 370 for AMD. I'm not sure for Intel. Let's go ahead and click to join that game. It requires a 290, I believe, a 290X. Once again, for AMD, I don't know what it is for NVIDIA. And 16 gigabytes of RAM.
Yeah,
16 gigs of RAM.
So I've got 32 gigs. I've got an 8350, and I've got a, what is that, a 260? 260 AMD card?
260X, I believe.
Yeah. And right now, just the game is using 40% of my CPU and 1.5 gigs of RAM.
Yeah, I'm using 1.6 gigs of RAM with 100% GPU and half of my CPU. I have an 8350 with a 7870 and 16 gigs of RAM. So, the game requires some ridiculous amount of stats, but I mean, how visually good it is. That's not a surprise. And you know what? Let's be serious. With all the things that are available now, you know, specs-wise, gaming-wise, I expect most games to have some ridiculous requirements. I expect it nowadays because with everything that's been coming out, it's I'm not surprised now. How good is this game? Okay, so now we know that the specs are ridiculous, but how good is this game? Well, we already said visually, it's great. I do like the cards. You do get a set of cards and you pick them early before you start the game. And then once you pick those cards, you know, they regenerate throughout the game. So one of the cards gives you grenades, and you constantly have those grenades, but you do have to wait a few, like, 10 seconds or 5 seconds for it to regenerate. Other things like a sniper rifle, shield, booster pack, stuff like that, that's all available, which is cool. I like that about the game. You can set that you sprint all the time. I just learned that. I thought that was not possible, but you can do that. I don't know. I've noticed that some of the guns are pretty weak. And I say that because I'm shooting somebody in the face 50 times, but yet I end up dying, so...
Minus 6.
So, yeah, it's,
We're securing the escape pod.
But overall, I mean, it is a fun game. Now, the beta doesn't give you... It gives you two maps, I believe. Okay, so you have Drop Zone, and then you have the other...
Two game types, you mean.
Or two game types, should I say. You have Drop Zone, which I noticed Drop Zone is one map.
Yeah, well, I haven't seen any other maps besides...
Yeah, I haven't seen any. I mean, I've played 23 matches, it said, and I haven't seen any other map in Drop Zone. I have not played the other one. I don't know the name of the other one. The other game type. So I don't know the actual name of it, but it's where you play... You have the big walking robot things. What are they called? I forgot. I feel so bad. Whatever. Do you have...
The AT-ATs?
Yes, the AT-ATs. Thank you. That is it. And then you, of course, have... you actually have ships that you can pilot.
That's a big shout-out to Mark Garrett over there at SourceFed.
Right?
She hates when people say AT-AT.
Oh, AT-AT. So, and you also have ships you can fly as well in that gameplay. I have not played that one yet. I'm not sure how I like it. I know in Battlefield, I don't like vehicles as much. So, I don't know. I don't know how I would feel about it. Overall, the game is fairly fun. Graphically, it's amazing, but is it a $60 game? That's the question. Because let's be serious. So me and Dalbor, we both tried the crew, and we, after playing the beta, that's not a $60 game. As much as we like car games, as much as we like those kind of car games, and we think Ubisoft's a great company, that was not a $60 game, so we didn't end up buying it brand new. But is this worth something to wait, or is it worth something to buy? I don't know. I'm on the fence right now. I'm not sure. I can't really decide. Yeah, I can't decide. I want to say, because graphically it's amazing, and overall it's fairly fun for an FPS game, I want to say yes, but at the same time, I don't know. There are certain things that I'm like, let me put it this way. As of now, Titanfall is still my favorite FPS game. So if I try to compare it to Titanfall, which obviously not the same game, but if I try to compare it to that FPS game, I don't know if I could buy this at a $60 price.
Honestly, I think this is going to be a great game for Star Wars fans.
It is. It absolutely... I do want to... Thanks for saying that. I do want to say that this is a very good game.
Yeah, I think this will be an amazing game for Star Wars fans. I think it's fun. I'm just not that guy, unfortunately. You know, I wish I could be, but I'm not that big of a fan.
Right.
So, but I think this will be a fantastic game for fans.
Well, as I mentioned before, I like the movies. I'm not a ginormous fan of the movies where I go nuts, you know, for the next movie or the next thing that comes out, Star Wars. So, you know, to me, it's not obviously hitting home. But that being said, I don't know. It's tough to say. I don't think I would buy a brand new.
Yeah. I mean, I think I'm definitely... I'm pretty much not on the fence.
Bro.
Don't do me like that, bro. I just don't think it's enough my flavor for it to be worth $60 for me.
Right.
I've spent $60 on several games in the last year, and it just hasn't proven worthy for me. Why is it not working? Five zip.
Not bad.
So the gameplay is pretty straightforward. You get these little charge-ups when you kill somebody or when you win a round. You can play up to 9 times, basically, because you get first to 5 is kind of the winner. Or first to beat the time.
First to beat the time, right. Now, the biggest thing in this particular game type that we're playing is make sure you're at your pods. You know, you take them over, you protect them, you make sure they get taken over by you. I think it takes about, I want to say if nobody takes it over on the other team, I think it takes total what would you say, 2 minutes to fully take it over?
Minute and a half, 2 minutes, something like that.
Something like that. So,
if you guys hear, just kind of as a side, if you guys are hearing kind of a choppiness, that's not the computer, because I play any other game and I don't have this issue. This game just really, really eats the...
It eats a lot of resources. I mean, this is definitely one of those games where you might want dual GPUs. You definitely, I would say, 32 gigs of RAM. Even though I'm not seeing the RAM being used as much as they as much as it's recommended to have 16, I don't see the RAM being used like that. So, I don't know why the recommendation for the RAM is so high.
I mean, it's right now I'm at 2.
Yeah, I'm at 2. It's climbing. So, I mean, maybe over time, I don't know, you know? Maybe over time it builds up and that's what happens. But once again, it is a game that has extremely good graphics. So I really can't stress that enough. It does have some amazing graphics. And that would explain why, you know, the GPU is being taxed and even the CPU. Because, yeah, I'm fairly steady at 49% for CPU usage. And 100 for GPU. But then again, I am using a 7870. They do, for recommended settings, the 290 is recommended. So
where did that come
from? That's even better than what I have, so.
I came right in after you to die.
Oh, did you?
I do the partner start, so I'm right behind you.
Oh, okay.
We got some on the right. And this is what I think. I think this is the kind of gameplay you could get out of this. I think you could get a lot of really good cooperative gameplay. Ah, this thing's going to eat me. Heal. So these things eat you.
Ooh, all right.
We have secured. Alright, where's the next one? Down.
Another pod has landed.
Ooh, not doing so hot right now.
Oh boy. Jesus. I don't know what that was.
And that's the thing, some games you're gonna do. Some games you're going to do good, some games you're not. There is definitely a lot going on because it's so graphically beautiful.
And I mean, look at it this way, guys. This is on low. This is everything on low.
Yeah, what you're seeing on his screen is on low. So that tells
you
that.
This is already better than most games that I've played. I mean, you see kind of the loss. You look real close. Whoa, son. Oh, that's... Yeah, my bad. My bad.
Oh, who took our pod here?
Nope. Ow. Maybe I need to boost my tracking. Controls. Soldier sensitivity?
Yeah, I haven't played with that part of it. I did see that. I don't know what that is. I don't know what they mean by that.
Let's see what happens. Ooh, okay. Oh, that's definitely that.
So what is that actually?
Soldier sensitivity is your mouse sensitivity. But it looks like you can control it. You can control it based on whether you're a soldier or in a vehicle, which is kind of cool.
Ah, I see.
I think that was a little high for me, though. So let's go back here, bump that down to about, say, 30 or so. Can we just get this?
I know. Whoa, they keep taking it over. They keep taking it over, and I don't know how, because we got a guy camping here. Now, guys, I do want to say this. This is a game you're going to be camping because you have to sit at your pods. At least for this kind of gameplay where you're playing the pod drops, you're going to have to camp there.
There it is.
We have picked up another escape pod signal.
Thermal imploder. And as you play it more, you kind of get the hang of it.
Oh, absolutely. Just like any other game. Now, you have one main weapon, so you always usually stay on that weapon. Like I said, a sniper is your burn card, if we're talking Titanfall terms. And it does replenish every time you use it, so it does take about 5 to 10 seconds to replenish. Some of the better cards do take 20 seconds to replenish, but that aspect of it is actually pretty cool. I do like that, so you never run out of grenades or anything like that, but you also can't spam them, so there's that as well. So where some games give you 3 grenades right off the bat and you can just spam those 3.
No, I'll stick with the shield. The shield is nice.
I like the shield. Having the shield is good. Now, that's one thing that does bother me about the game. So, yes, the shield takes longer to charge, but you also have to pick up energy stuff across the map. And if you haven't picked up any energy to replenish the shield, then you will not be able to use it in the next map either until you do end up replenishing it with the energy stuff that you have to pick off the ground. So that's kind of one thing I don't like it, because it's basically a double. Nice.
That's 5-zip.
5-zip.
Deuce. 2-for.
But yeah, I mean, there's really nothing much to say. I mean, it's a fun game. I wouldn't say it's nowhere near the fun I have in Titanfall, I don't think.
Right.
At least not for me.
And I think that's where the fandom's going to come into play. I think it's going to be way better of a game for fans.
I agree.
Let's back out and let's do one of the other one. Attack.
Yeah, let's do it.
You guys see this, the choppiness here. And that's on low.
Yeah, it takes a lot of resources. Alright, so let's get out of this.
Pretty. My CPU's at 100. It was at 75% for that. So let's back out. Quit. Come on, buddy.
So you go ahead and pick the Water Assault. So one's called Drop Zone. The one we just played is called Drop Zone. The other one's called Walker Assault. That's the AT-ATs.
Play. If you haven't yet.
There's also Supremacy, Fighter Squadron, Blast, Cargo, and Droid Rod.
I got to re-invite you to the party.
Right. But all those other ones are not available in beta. Once again, Supremacy, Fighter Squadron, Blast, Cargo, and Droid Run. Those are available in the full game. They're not available in the beta. Although, I mean, I think overall these two kind of give you in how the game is.
Yeah, you get some soldier action, some vehicle action.
Right, so, and we'll try out this Walker Assault to see how that is.
Feels like this one's loading even slower. Although that snow, at least in that image. Oh.
Except my partner in my...
I will. It's going to be just a moment here.
Because I think even though we're in a party, I think we do have to be set as partners to be on the same thing, on the same team.
That could be it. Give me 1 second here. I've got Darth Vader on my screen. It says this session is no longer available.
Yeah, so the 7870 is at 100% usage.
All right. Oh, I'm sure the graphics card's at 100%. I've got the 2260X, I think is what we said.
Yeah, you have the AMD 260X. Alright, there we go. Your party has just joined the game.
We're going to be rebels. We're going to be rebel scum.
I mean, whatever.
I'm sorry, it looks like... Is it just going to be us?
I hope not. It looks like other people are playing that drop zone instead, but let's see what happens here. Now, I do notice in the loading screens, the CPU does jump to 100%. So that's...
Yeah, I'm sitting at 75 right now.
That's impressive that in the loading screen, that does happen.
All right. Press to join. Come on. Man,
this game made me want to build a computer.
Seriously. Come on.
66. By the way, this the Walker Assault that we're doing right now is a 40-player game. 40 players.
We're gonna. I'm level 4? I am level 4. Let's unlock this.
Speaking of that, so I'm set on Ultra. I turned off my anti-aliasing, and with the specs that I have with the 8350 and the 7870, my average FPS is 81. I do turn off vertical sync as well, so that's why I'm able to reach these higher ones. So max hit has already hit at 201. And minimum has been 74, so I've been averaging at 81 so far for FPS.
Activate uplinks. Alright, let's do this.
Which is not bad at all. Alright, let's try this out. Let's see.
The uplink station has been activated.
So it's still another game of control.
What's that?
It's basically just another game of control.
Well, it looks like it is. Yeah, you have to activate the satellites or towers. You obviously defend them.
They're in those things. All right.
Nice. Oh, look, it's Luke Skywalker.
Move it. Oh, goodness.
Interesting. This is... It's a lot of people. 40...
Yeah, this is a much larger game.
This is a much larger game. Wow. It's definitely interesting, I guess is the way to put it.
Jeez.
I'm trying to think what other game has 40... 40 man FPS games.
Uplink signal lost.
Oh, nice grenade.
We gotta stop him. We gotta stop him. What?
Jesus. Okay, I mean, at least I got that grenade kill, but man, there is so much going on right now. It's easy die.
Some sort of force field. Okay.
Yeah, the Fort Blue's force field that you can jump in. Now there are, what's cool about this one is there are turrets you can get into to use against players and stuff like that.
Man, they are just all over this. Let's see here. Let's switch to that.
I think that was my first melee in the game.
So I had a couple melees in the other game side, definitely. Oh.
Here we are.
Punks.
Oh. Okay.
They got turrets all over the place.
They sure do.
Sheesh. What's that? Oh, yes.
Uplink has been cut. Our bombers need that signal.
Now, I want to know how you activate the Luke Skywalker thing. I think
the
that's
X-Wing,
like...
I've got it. It was a pickup.
Oh, okay. So it's a pickup.
It was a pickup. I think you just gotta stay alive until it happens.
The walker is exposed.
Not doing good on this one. I'm trying to figure out which one. I mean, this is fun because there's a lot of people, but I feel like this might be just too much people.
I want to know how to, you know. Master Publius. Yes, orbital strike. I don't even know how you got that. Can I get in this?
Uplink activated.
Whoa. Okay, I think I need to switch weapons here.
Man, thank you. I'm glad somebody killed him. Now, how do we get into those tunnels?
Yeah, right?
We spawned into those tunnels, but how do you get into them? Oh, I think I found it. Good.
Walker targeted by our Y-Wing.
Jesus. Man, I don't even. I just looked at my score. Let's hope it doesn't show on this recording, because it's terrible.
I showed it.
It is awful.
Hey, it's almost as bad as mine. Actually, I think mine's better than yours.
Well,
but I think you're just taking more of a active role.
That's it. That's what I'm doing. Yeah. We'll go there. I do like the music. The music, What? Oh, Luke Skywalker is a god. He can get you through walls.
Why are we practicing?
What do you keep saying Luke Skywalker? Do you mean the X-Wing or what?
No, there's Luke Skywalkers running around with a lightsaber.
Oh, no. What the hell? Oh.
Yeah, I don't know if you noticed that.
No, I did not notice that, actually. I got stomped by the walker, actually. This is right there.
We have activated an uplink station. Prepare for enemy attack.
Coming in from the right side if you're inside.
I was on the turret.
They were coming from the right.
what the frag?
Dude.
Right on top of us.
How do I, like, can I get into a, how do I get into a... Need both uplinks.
Oh man, this is not pretty. Come on, are you serious? That's ridiculous. Well, I kind of hope I never spawn outside ever again.
There's turrets out there, though. Come on. I'm going for the second uplink.
There's just a lot going on. You got the AT-ATs, you got the airships, you got Luke Skywalker running.
We've got all the links. What the heck? Yeah, we're defending the daggone links, but
apparently
I don't even know how that just happened. Oh, orbital strike. That's fine. Like a weapon or something? Can I get into a X-Wing? I bet you put me in an X-Wing, we have no problems.
Right? Wow, that's three guys right there. Four guys, my bad. I'm saying, how do you get in a spaceship? How do you get into an AT-AT, like, any of it?
Our bomber's got a lock on the Imperial Walker.
Yeah, good. Bomb them out of existence. Man.
You can't even...
Oh, come on, I'm right in front of them.
You can't even get out of the way.
I'm saying, like, that's not even fair. How you gonna put me right in front of them?
Can't even get out of the way. That's
all right. Let's see what we have here.
That's just. Oh no! Stop it.
Y-wings are targeting.
The walker's exposed face. I mean, I get what you're saying.
AT-AT is about to open fire at the main power generator. Take it out.
Ah! Darth Vader just killed me. Please tell me they aimed the orbital strike at one of the AT-ATs.
Oh, there's Vader.
Yeah, I saw Vader.
There, oh man. Well, I will say,
this is not my game type, let me tell you that.
No, this is
this is way too much for me. See, here's the thing, the flip side is when I play Halo and do BTB, I love it. But this is, there's just, because of the vehicle action, there's too much.
Yeah,
There's too much. If you give me, like, if you give me a new hope, you know what I'm saying? Give me a new hope. Let me plan out the attack. Then we could do Empire.
Right. Absolutely. No, that's a... I guess maybe if we learn more on how to get in vehicles and stuff like that, because we definitely weren't. I got killed at least 50 times. So, I think we're gonna end here.
I think we'll call it. I actually think my game froze. Right now it's at 2.3 gigs right now.
So, final thought, I don't know why they require so much RAM, because it doesn't go really much over 2 gigs usage when I was playing just now. You definitely need a really good GPU.
I think if you're going to play this...
If you're going to play this, I recommend a 390 PC. Or a 390X.
Yeah,
If you like NVIDIA, then I say a 980 would probably... 980 or 980 Ti, obviously, but 980 Ti is quite a few bucks more than the 980. But Intel or processor-wise, obviously an 8350 or an 8370 right now, or that's, of course, on the AMD side of things. Or if you're Intel, a 6700K 1151 socket, that's then your quad-core, or go with their 5930K, which is their 2011 socket. Just because with how much this was utilizing on both, that's what I would recommend. But then again, this is a beta, so maybe they'll change some stuff before the actual final drop comes out. But at the current moment, it definitely uses a lot of resources. My final thoughts, very, very, very good-looking game.
It's gorgeous. I think the graphics in this game are as good as the original trilogy.
Sure.
Yeah, I think visually it looks as good as the original trilogy.
Listen, visually it's amazing. Mechanically wise, like the actual mechanics of the game are overall fairly fun. I got used to them pretty quickly. Obviously learning the whole how to get into ships and stuff with the other style game is something to get used to. Is it a $60 game? For me, it's a tough call. I wanna say it's not for me. But that being said, I think anybody who's a Star Wars fan and a gaming fan and also first-person shooter fan are gonna like this game quite a lot.
I have to agree. I think it's fun. I think it's enjoyable enough for as far as a shooter.
Right.
I think the big part of this is definitely going to be nostalgia. I think it's going to be for fans. The real reason I even wanted to try this out is, on SourceFed, I watch Maude Garrett and Steve Zaragoza get super, super hyped about it. And I just kind of wanted to see if that was deserved in and of itself, or if that was more of a fandom thing.
Right.
And I feel like it's going to definitely be more of a fandom thing.
And here's the other thing. I have not tried yet, obviously, and I don't think they offer it in the beta. I'll check that out in a little bit here. But I haven't tried the missions, the single player stuff that you can do with partners and stuff like that.
There is. So, we actually do have that in beta.
So that's something to try out to see if there's actually some kind of storyline that you can play through without having to play a multiplayer game. That might add to the game, which will then obviously add to the, is it worth a $60 game? But at the current moment, just being played as a multiplayer game, I can't say that I would buy it at a $60 game. I'm not saying that I wouldn't look for it maybe if it was on sale for the holidays or something like that. But overall, as a brand new game, I don't know if I would be... I don't think it's the game for me. Obviously, I'm not the audience for this game.
I think that's kind of the big part of it, is that there is a specific audience for this game. I think that audience will buy it. I think that audience will buy it brand new. I think it'll definitely make money. I don't see myself buying it unless it's, Black Friday kind of deal, used copy, something like that.
Right.
If it comes with a graphics card or something.
Sure.
If you buy the graphics card that you need to play it and it comes with it, absolutely I'll play it.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, it's right now is just it's quite insane on what the settings are required for it. And I mean, yeah, I'm using 8350, and obviously Intel's had so many newer processors since this processor came out from AMD. But that being said, I mean, that's still an 8-core processor and 16 gigs of RAM, and 7870 is an older card, but I'm just a little shocked on how much it really does require to play. But it is a nice looking game, so I guess I'll give it that.
It's gorgeous, yeah.
But well, I think what do you think? What do you
I think it's good, man. I think it's a good game. I think it's fun. I think it seems to me like both the two types of game that we tried definitely are basically the same thing, just one's way bigger and way more intricate.
Right.
You know, it's essentially just a game of control.
Yeah.
So that's to me, those are my favorite types of games because it's kind of a clear objective in multiplayer. It's not to say that I'm not a fan of deathmatch, but I'm definitely more of a fan of control because there's more than just kill streaks that get you the win.
Yeah, no, absolutely. My biggest thing was when we just played that last match, I wasn't obviously a fan of the vehicles because, as you can tell, I mean, all we were doing is dying once somebody had control of those giant vehicles. So I don't know how I don't know how fair that part of it really is. So once again, it kind of falls into the same thing with Battlefield 4. It's just, I don't know. I'm not a for some reason with Titanfall with mechs, it works really well. They did a really good job meshing the two.
I think that's. I think Titanfall falls into more of, you know, because it's more of an exo thing. It's not so much a vehicle as it is an extension of you.
Of you, right?
Yeah. So it's still an FPS. It's still walking around and hand-to-hand combat, essentially, just more of just a larger scale. Whereas with this, you have fast-moving vehicles that are hard to track, and if you're not in a vehicle, it's going to be almost impossible.
No, absolutely. But that's it. That's really all I have to say for the game. For me, I don't know if I'll be going out and buying it for $60. I might save my $60 for something else.
I'll definitely be saving my $60 for something else. And like I said, if it comes with a GPU that I'm picking up, or if it comes, you know, if I find it cheap used, yeah, definitely. But
yeah,
you know, if it's you know, part of the winter sale on Steam or something on a good price,
or even on Amazon, because I know Amazon did Shadow of Modar last year, which was a brand new game, literally a month before the sales came out, and it was $20 off. Yeah. So
I think if it's not a, you know, burning passion of yours, if you're not a Star Wars fanatic, I think you could definitely wait it out for a month or two until the winter sales come into play.
Absolutely.
And then pick it up probably way cheaper. And I would say probably be better off for it, personally speaking, just because I'm not a huge fan of the series. I mean, I am a fan. I'm just not that big of a fan where I would give $60 for a game that to me is not as good as other games that I'm playing. It's not as good as Destiny, and I barely play Destiny.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree with that. So yeah, that's it. That's my thoughts. Let's finish it up.
Appreciate you guys for watching. As always, I have been Cerebro, also known as Dalibor, and
Harris.
And appreciate you guys for watching.
Oh, and make sure to check out our giveaway video, guys. We still have that going on, bunch of giveaways. Make sure you take a look at that so you can get in on the giveaway.
Yeah, get in on that giveaway. We got tons of game stuff. T3G bundle, we got headsets,
mouse pad, I mean a bunch of things, so
tons of stuff, so get in on that.
All right,
see ya.